Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. Welcoming myself back as well. I know it has been a very long time. I kind of took like a year, I think a year, close to a year, completely off. I just got really overwhelmed with uni and life, and I just could not manage YouTube on top of all of that. But I am back now and I am very excited to continue to make videos again, because I really missed it. It is something that I did really love. And now that we're getting into like the break of uni and life has kind of calmed down in a way, so now I am ready to start making videos again. For today, I thought I would share all the books that I have read so far this year, just so I can catch you guys up on my reading and what I've been reading and my thoughts on everything for the books that I've read in 2021. I think this year I have read 29 books, so it's only going to be the books from January to the end of May, and then I will do a June wrap up at the end of this month so you can see the books that I've read this month. But yeah, starting with January, the first three books were the Heartstopper graphic novels. These are my first three reads of the year. I had already read them. Volumes 1 and 2 were a reread, and then volume 3 was a new read, so I reread these two so I could read this one. And they all got 5 out of 5 stars. Like, it's such a comforting read and it's such a comforting series, and it's just so cute and happy and I love it so much, and it was a really good decision to start off 2021 with reading some really good comfort reads. So I loved all these and I gave them 5 out of 5 stars. The next book that I read was Aurora Burning. I read this in January. It is the sequel to Aurora Rising, which is like a sci-fi series. I really enjoyed the sequel. I didn't enjoy it as much as the first book, but I did like it. This one took me a lot longer to get through. I wasn't as invested, and the characters just didn't really feel the same as they did in the first book. So I ended up giving this a 3 out of 5 stars, but I still really enjoyed it. And I can't wait for the last book to come out this year, which I think is called Aurora's Ending, which comes out in November of this year. I'm so excited to finish the series because it is such a fun just sci-fi novel where all these kids just try and save the world, and it's just super fun, so I gave this 3 out of 5 stars. The next book that I read in January was The Invisible Life of Addie LaRue. I actually started this in December of 2020, but I didn't end up finishing it, and I finished it in January of 2021, and I absolutely love this book so much. It is definitely one of my new favourites. This is the Forbidden Planet edition. It's super beautiful. I love the blue in the end pages and under the cover. It's just so stunning. And yeah, it is also signed by V.E. Schwab. I really love this edition and I love the story so much. It was absolutely amazing. It was so magical and whimsical, and just the vibes were just all there, like the devil and Henry and Addie and just living forever and how that affects her and the people around her and how she has to go about living with everyone forgetting about her. It was just so amazing and I took so much from it. I just love it so much. Easy 5 out of 5 stars and definitely one of my favorite books ever. The next book that I read was When I Arrived at the Castle by Emily Carroll, which is a graphic novel. I think it follows this girl who goes to like this creepy house, and there's vampires and there's monsters and there's like all these weird stuff happening in the house. I think she gets like kidnapped or something and like locked in the room, and there's lots of blood, and it was just immaculate vibes. I absolutely loved all the gruesome gory bits and I absolutely loved it. I gave it 4 out of 5 stars. It was such a good graphic novel, super quick to read, and just if you like vampires, if you like werewolves, if you like the gory locked in a house, then you should definitely pick this up because it was so good. And the next book that I read was Horrid by Katrina Leno. This was so good. I really enjoyed it. I ended up giving it 5 out of 5 stars, and it's my first Katrina Leno. I really loved it. I haven't really read a lot of like the horror haunted house books, so this I would say was one of my first ones that I read, and I just absolutely fell in love with the atmosphere and the vibes and the creepiness of like hearing noises in her bedroom and then like creeping down the hall. It truly felt like a horror movie to me, but I know this fell flat for a lot of people just because like they've read so much better horror haunted house stories, but for me I really loved it, and I haven't read a lot of them, so this was like one of the first few that I have read, and I really loved it. I loved the woman in the story, the hidden creepy childhood that you never know about, and like all the family secrets, and like the eating of the books and the roses, and just all the creepy stuff that happens in this book. I loved it so much, and it was so, so good. I gave it 5 out of 5 stars. And it was probably one of my favourite books that I've read so far this year. I don't think it's a favourite of all time, but definitely a favourite for this year. The next book that I read was How the King of Elfthane Learned to Hate Stories by Holly Black. This is a collection of stories following Prince Cardin, who is the character in the Cruel Prince series, and it is just a collection of stories with like stunning illustrations throughout. And it's really beautiful, and I really enjoyed it. I gave it 3 out of 5 stars. It was nothing special. It's just some fun stories that added to the world, but it was nothing like out of this world amazing. But yeah, I did really like it, and the illustrations were absolutely stunning. But yeah, nothing that blew me away, so 3 out of 5 stars. The next book that I read was a graphic novel memoir, which is Stitches by David Small. I did really like this. I didn't end up rating it just because it is a non-fiction book and it is a memoir, so I don't really feel comfortable rating a book based on someone else's life experiences. But basically it follows our main character, David, who is just going through his life. He had a terrible childhood, and it's just about him living and going through all the shit that he goes through. And yeah, I did really enjoy it, and it's definitely a quick read, but really hard-hitting. The next book that I read was Across the Green Grass Fields by Seanan Maguire, which is the next book in the Wayward Children series. This book I gave 3 out of 5 stars. Didn't love it as much as some of the others in the series, but I really did appreciate the LGBTQ rep in it. I really liked exploring the new world of like the unicorns and things like that. So I did really like it, and I enjoyed being back with our characters, but it just wasn't as great as some of the others in my opinion. It just didn't have like the substance and the things that I really loved in the book. But yeah, still a really, really good continuation of the series. I really enjoyed it. I give it 3 out of 5 stars. The next book that I read was In the Lolo Woods by Cameron Maria Machado. I know she has written the book A Dream House or something. It's like a horror memoir thing. But this is a graphic novel that she has written, and I really loved it. I gave it 4 out of 5 stars. It is a horror graphic novel. It follows some characters trying to figure out what's going on in their town. There's some weird supernatural things happening that is kind of like hidden from everyone, and they are just trying to figure out what is causing havoc in their town and what the supernatural is happening. And yeah, I really liked it. The art was absolutely beautiful, and I just love the horror aspect. Yeah, it was really good. Solid graphic novel, and I definitely recommend it. The next book that I read was Saga Volume 2. This was a reread. I reread this so I could continue on with the series. I really like this. Saga is one of my favourite graphic novel series. Art, beautiful, the concept of sci-fi fantasy, two species warring against each other because two people of different species fall in love and they have a child, and the story is told through the child's point of view, and it's just absolutely stunning, and I can't wait to continue on with the series. I think I'm up to volume 5 now, and it's getting better and better. Definitely different from the first few volumes, but yeah, there's the world and the characters are so much more complex now, and yeah, I really love this one so much. I gave it 4 out of 5 stars. The next book that I read was The Death of Vivek OJ. Oh, this book was so good. It's by Akweke Emezi, who wrote one of my favourite books of last year, which was Freshwater. It was my favourite book of last year, and this is their latest release, I believe, and it follows Vivek, who is a Nigerian, and I believe non-binary, but I'm not 100% sure. It follows them and their friends, and them just figuring out who they are and their identity and their sexuality and who they are as a person, as well as, you know, building friendships and trying to fit in with their family's kind of rules and things. And it was so, so beautiful. It was heartbreaking, and I just loved it so much. I gave it 5 out of 5 stars. It is definitely one of my favourite books of this year, and I absolutely love everything that Akweke Emezi writes. I haven't read Pet by them yet, but I really, really want to, because Freshwater is one of my favourite books of all time, and I really loved Death of Vivek OJ as well. So yeah, 2 5-star books from that author, so I definitely want to read their third book. Hopefully I can solidify them as a favourite author of mine. But yeah, I definitely loved Vivek OJ. So heartbreaking, I think he even cried. And yeah, I definitely recommend you pick this one up if you're looking for a very spiritual, heartbreaking, moving novel. The next book that I read was Book Love by Debbie Tung. This is a graphic novel and it's all about being in love with books and being a reader, and it's just like lots of different pages dedicated to what it is like to love books and things. Just really cute little things about, you know, like bending the spines and like dog-earing the pages and like the smell of books and stuff. It was really cute. I really loved some of the pages and I ended up giving it a 4 out of 5 stars. It was nothing special, but yeah, it was super duper cute, and the art style was actually really cool too, so I definitely recommend that one. The next book that I read was Saga Volume 3 by Brian K. Vaughan and Fiona Staples. This is the third book, and I really like this one too. It kind of goes on a different story. We're introduced to a couple new characters, and it kind of is following their story as well as the main character's story in the first couple volumes. So I really enjoyed this one. I ended up giving it a 3 out of 5 stars though. I didn't love it as much as the first two, but it's definitely still a strong series in my opinion. I just didn't love this one as much as the other two. The next book that I have read is Lore by Alexandra Bracken. I was so excited for this coming out because I love The Darkest Minds. When I first got into reading, it was one of my favourite series, so I was super excited to read Lore. I heard it was like about Greek gods, and it's like Hunger Games but with Greek gods, and I was so sold on that premise, but unfortunately didn't really live up to my expectations. I thought it really fell flat, dragged so much, and I found it was very repetitive. Like, one minute they'd be getting caught, and then the next they'd escape, and then they'd huddle to make a plan, and then they'd go back out, and then they'd get caught, and then they, like, it was a very repetitive plot line, and I just didn't really connect well with any of the characters. But I still enjoyed it for what it was, but it just didn't blow me away like I thought it might, so I ended up giving it 3 out of 5 stars. The next book that I read was Loveless by Alice Oseman. I really loved this, especially being someone in uni myself. I could relate a lot to like the uni life, which I really enjoyed. I hadn't really read many books with ace characters before, so I really enjoyed reading about that and learning about what it is like to be ace, and I really loved it. I loved the characters and the friendships and just the clubs and everything, and the theatre. It was such a memorable book. I listened to the audiobook, which was so good, and I just really loved the book. I think it was solid, and I enjoyed it so much, and I'm definitely going to continue reading Alice Oseman's books because I really love this one. The next book that I read was Lainey by Alex Porter. This was such a weird book and I don't really know how to feel about it. I gave it 2 out of 5 stars. It was just bizarre. Didn't really understand it. Some of the words were like in a spiral and things, which I think is super cool, like when books do that, but just the concept of the book just went over my head, and I just don't think I was in the right space to read that book. I might try reading it again in the future, but yeah, didn't really connect with it, didn't feel anything for it, so I only gave it 2 out of 5 stars. The next book that I read was Pumpkinheads by Rambo Rowell and Faith Erin Hicks. This is a super cute graphic novel following two characters who are working at a pumpkin patch for the last time before they leave to college. I enjoyed it, I gave it 3 out of 5 stars, nothing special, but it was cute, art style was fine, and yeah, it was cute. It was another book to tick off on my TBR, and I enjoyed it, but it was nothing amazing. The next book that I read was Saga Volume 4. I gave this one 4 out of 5 stars. I like this a lot better than the third one, and I just cannot wait to see where the story is going. I actually have Volume 5 and 6 on my TBR for June, so hopefully I can get to those this month, because I'm really loving where the story is going. The next book that I read is A Court of Silver Flames by Sarah J. Maas. I'm sure you're not surprised that I gave this 5 out of 5 stars, as everybody else did. It was amazing. I love Nesta and Cassian as a couple. I love the woman in this and their journey and up the mountain, just that entire scene. It was amazing. I just could not get over how good this was. I love it so much. Nesta and her growth, and just, oh, it was everything that I could have wanted and more. So I really love this. I gave it 5 out of 5 stars and another favourite of the year so far. The next book that I read was Homebody by Rupi Kaur. This is her third poetry book out. This one I gave 3 out of 5 stars. I did really enjoy it. I love a lot of her poetry, but this one I just didn't connect with as much as her other two. It is a very, like, cultural and societal and, like, environmental kind of vibe for that book. And I thought some of them were absolutely amazing. Like, I took photos of my favourite poems and things, but I just didn't connect with it as much as I did the other two, which is fine. But, yeah, I gave it 3 out of 5 stars, but I will definitely continue to read her poetry because I just love it so much. But, yeah, this one didn't hit as hard as her first two. Next book that I read was, of course, my favourite book of all time, Daisy Jones and the Six by Taylor Jenkins Reid. This was my 5th reread of this book. Honestly, I'm not sorry. I love this book with my whole heart. I cried again. It doesn't stop hurting. The more you read it, it just packs a punch every time. I treated myself to a reread of my favourite book because I think it should be read a million times, and I love it so much. So I read it for the 5th time, and I am so glad that I did because it was so, so good. Again. The next book that I read was We Hunt the Flame by Hafsa Faisal. This has been on my TBR for the longest time, and I'm so glad I finally read it. I listened to the audiobook, which was a really good way to go because a lot of the names in this book were, like, so hard to pronounce and I could not figure out how you would say that, so the audiobook really helped in that way. I really loved it, just the vibes and the atmosphere and the world building and everything, and being in the forest of the Ars was so cool, and I just really loved it, and the characters, oh, so good, and I cannot wait for the sequel, which has already come out, and I really want to get my hands on it. But yeah, I gave this 4 out of 5 stars, and I cannot wait to read the second one. But yeah, I really love this, the characters, the plot, everything was so good about it, and I definitely recommend you pick it up if you haven't already. The next book that I read was Feudia. This follows our main character who has a dream to be a soccer player, but then she gets kind of involved with her childhood best friend romantically, and he tries to support her, but also he's a soccer player himself, so he wants to follow his dreams, but he also wants to be with her, but they have different dreams. It just follows the main character fighting for her dreams and her family who don't believe in it and think she should be, you know, the typical woman stereotypes. It's really good. I really loved how the aspects of the dreams and fighting for your dreams and working as a team and just being with your friends and your family, and I loved how it was kind of roped in with falling in love, like giving that up for what you're chasing, your dreams, and not letting anyone get in the way of that or let you down. And yeah, I really loved it. I gave it 4 out of 5 stars and I highly recommend it. The next book that I read was Back to You by Tammy Robinson. This is a book by a New Zealand author. I believe it is also set in New Zealand, although it's not specifically said where. And I liked it. I gave it 2 out of 5 stars, not because I didn't like it, just because it wasn't really my kind of book. I don't read a lot of romance, although I do want to. Main character was fine, but she also had a lot of flaws. She was really bitchy. Some of the things she did was just, like, really annoying, and she was acting like a little child, and I just think she should have been a grown-up woman about some of the decisions she made. Like the family aspects and reconnecting with her dad, but yeah, didn't really vibe the romance because it was like a one-day romance, and then the rest was online because he was moving away, and yeah, didn't really vibe it, didn't really feel connected with it, but I did really like the family aspects and how the main character reconnects with her dad. But other than that, not a lot of feelings towards it, so I gave it 2 out of 5 stars. The next book that I read was Abbott, which is a graphic novel. It was so good, I gave it 4 out of 5 stars. It is about a female detective. She's black. She, I believe, is either bisexual or pan. It's not stated, but there is a female kind of fling that happens towards the end. And she's a detective. She's working on a case where there is these supernatural things happening, weird shit, and they're killing off black people. So she is trying to get her voice out there saying, you know, like, about white cops, how they're racist and all that, and it was so, so good. I loved all the discussions about culture, about race, about police brutality, and about being a woman and being black, and it was so good, and it, like, just weaved with supernatural horror aspects like perfection. And it was really, really good, and I honestly should feel like I should give it 5 stars because it was just that good. But yeah, I ended up giving it 4 stars, but it's more of a 5 stars. I have 2 more books left to go. The second to last is Lord of Shadows. I just finished reading this a few days ago, and this took me 5 months to read. I really liked it, but at the same time, it dragged so much. I just didn't feel the same love that I felt for the first book. Lady Midnight, I gave 5 out of 5 stars. I flew through it, but this book just wasn't the same mark for me. It took me so long to get through. It just dragged and dragged and dragged. I didn't feel like there was much action going on. It was just more like conversations and character stuff, which generally is fine, but I think I need a mix of both, like plot and characters, because this just felt like it was so long and I just wanted it to be over with. Although the last 100 pages was immaculate, 5 out of 5 stars, but the rest just took too long. I think it should have been shorter. I just didn't connect to it as much as the first book, so I ended up giving it 3 out of 5 stars. Don't hate me, I know it is a lot of people's favourite in the Dark Artificers series, but I didn't love it as much. I did still enjoy it though. And the last book that I have read, the most recent book that I have finished, is The Poet X by Elizabeth Acevedo. I absolutely loved it, I gave it 5 out of 5 stars. It follows the Amara, who is trying to find her voice through slam poetry, find her voice in her family and in her school and in her community. And she is constantly being told by her family to be quiet and to be silent and just be a respectable lady of the church, and she doesn't want that. She wants to be heard. Amazing story, and I loved Ziomara's journey of finding her voice and finding her friends, finding what it means to fall in love and build friendships, and I think it was so good, and I definitely want to pick up more of Elizabeth Acevedo's books because this is the first I've read of hers and I really loved it. So that is it. Those are all the books that I have read in 2021 so far. I hope that you guys enjoyed this and that it let you catch up on what I've been reading this year while I've been off YouTube. Yeah, I hope it gave you a good view of my reading and my tastes and what I have enjoyed and not enjoyed this year. I really want to get back into filming videos, but bear with me while I'm in my last year of university, which is absolutely killing me. So bear with me as I get back into it. It will probably be a slow process to begin with, but yeah, I'm really happy to be back and I missed it so much. So thank you guys so much for watching. I hope you stick around if you enjoy. Thank you for watching and I will see you very soon in my next video. Bye.